Follow the journey of William Wes Ozier and take the first step on the path to discovering how to make your life and the world sustainable. William W.R. Ozier, Wes, is a lead AP who spent nearly 10 years working in the Arcosani Project, the Ecosa Institute, and the Lost Valley Educational Center. During that time, Wes was a contributing writer to the magazines Earth Odyssey and The Noise. This book is a compilation of his top 30 published articles on varying topics in green design, from arcology to xeriscaping. Easy to read and packed with information, this book gives both a technical and personal look into the developing and sustainable world around us. William's Ecopedia, Volume 1, Topics in Sustainability from Arcology to Xeriscaping, copyright June 2010. All article text in this book is the intellectual property of William W.R. Ozier. Many of them appear in written form in The Noise and Earth Odyssey magazine and other publications. See their respective websites for their article archives. Published works are the intellectual property rights of their respective publishers and cannot be reprinted without their permission. This book is dedicated to all of the pioneers who have and still are working hard to lay the foundations for a sustainable future. Table of Contents, Buckminster Fuller, page 26. Buckminster Fuller. Many people interested in a sustainable future for humanity have heard of a man named Buckminster Fuller, an engineer and futurist who achieved notoriety in the 1930s. In his 30s, Fuller's life was essentially a disaster. His first child had died, he was bankrupt, unemployed, with a wife and newborn to support. Under these pressures, he retreated into alcohol and became suicidal. On the verge of ending his own life, Fuller instead decided to devote his life to an experiment to discover what the little, penniless, unknown individual might be able to do effectively on behalf of all humanity. From this goal came over 30 years of work that still affects us today and may yet still impact the future of humanity. Buckminster Fuller is probably most famous for his design of the geodesic dome. Though Fuller had the patent, he is not exactly the one who designed it. A geodesic dome is a spherical structure composed of smaller repeating triangles. Geodesic domes are far more prolific in society than most people realize. While their most widespread use is in the construction of storage tanks for petroleum or other liquid chemicals, the Epcot Center at Walt Disney is perhaps the most famous geodesic dome. However, there is an impressive array of large structures that use the geodesic dome design. The physical geometry of the dome, made of triangular sections, provides a high, perhaps the highest possible, ratio of structural strength to material used, as well as the greatest ratio of enclosed volume. These two factors of the geodesic dome typify Fuller's approach, one of maximum efficiency. He felt that by engineering the maximum efficiency of human society, we would use the least amount of resources while at the same time accomplishing the most. Not only did he believe that this quest for efficiency would provide the most benefit for mankind, but at the same time we would live lighter on the earth, providing the most benefit for nature as well. While the geodesic dome is Fuller's most famous and ubiquitous contribution to the modern age, he had many other projects that gained him fame and notoriety as a brilliant thinker and futurist. At the core of Fuller's approach was a concept he labeled as Dymaxion, a contraction of the phrase dynamic maximum tension, which in the mind of Fuller implied the greatest possible efficiency in all technological endeavors. Fuller applied his concepts of efficiency to the issue of housing and designed the 1,000 square foot Dymaxion home. In essence, the Dymaxion home was a round design made from sheet metal, cut and stamped into repeated forms that, when assembled, formed something like a small silo. The structural design was strong and aerodynamic, able to withstand near hurricane force winds. It was able to heat and cool naturally by harnessing the thermal dome effect and supposedly able to capture rainwater. The hyper-efficient bathroom used a waterless toilet and a steam shower, which would supposedly use only one cup of water per wash. Electricity would be provided by a diesel generator, which could run off vegetable oils. The circular-shaped house was designed to rest all of its weight on a single pillar in the center, meaning they needed a very small footprint for their foundation. In fact, the whole structure could be lifted off the central support strut. Light enough to be lifted by a helicopter, Fuller envisioned that these hyper-efficient homes could actually be moved from one location to another, so if the family within had to relocate due to job or other factor, they could literally take their house with them. He envisioned that in cities, Dymaxion homes could be stacked on top of each other to create ad hoc skyscrapers where land was in short supply. All in all, the design, which is the first modern off-grid home design, was extremely efficient, cheap to construct, mass-producible, and versatile. In meshing his engineering with social issues, Fuller had intended for the post-World War II industrial might of America to turn from the war machine to producing these homes en masse, thereby providing efficient housing as well as jobs on a massive scale. There were only two prototypes made, and in 1948, a hybridized version of a Dymaxion home was constructed. Despite all the advantages of the Dymaxion home, the idea never caught on due to several criticisms of the design, as well as business mismanagement by Fuller and his partner. Many felt that as a home, it lacked internal privacy, and to many, it lacked any aesthetic appeal. One description characterized the Dymaxion home as life in a biscuit tin. And while highly efficient, the design allowed for little to no individual expression. He also designed a Dymaxion car, which was teardrop shaped for maximum aerodynamics, had three wheels, could carry 11 passengers, with a top speed of 120 miles per hour and able to get 30 to 50 miles per gallon. Only three of them were ever built. Unfortunately, one was demolished in a highly visible fatal accident, which gave the impression the design was unsound. Of course, there are those who feel the design was unpopular with the car industry and corporations because it would be a threat to high profit margins. While the Dymaxion car never caught on, I believe there is a similarity between the Dymaxion car and the ubiquitous VW bus. He even designed the Dymaxion map that is said to represent the land masses of Earth in perfect scale, something many standard maps and spherical globes don't do. In 1995, scientists discovered a complex carbon molecule that resembles a geodesic dome. The molecule was named the Buckminster Fullerene, or Buckyball. Due to their geodesic shape, they are among the strongest molecular structures known, appear to be superconductive, and have a host of other dazzling molecular properties. Buckyballs may replace silicon in future electronic devices, are already finding a myriad of applications in the material sciences, and in 1996 earned their discoverers a Nobel Prize. Fuller did not invent the Buckyball, but the physical reasons that his domes are so hyper-efficient is the same physical reasons, albeit on an atomic scale, that Buckyballs are such an amazing compound. He was definitely onto something. If you ask me, one of the main reasons Fuller's designs didn't catch on is because people felt that as an engineer, he ignored aesthetics. Fuller himself said, "When I'm working on a problem, I never think about beauty. I only think about how to solve the problem. But when I have finished it, if the solution is not beautiful, I know it is wrong." So it's not that he was incognizant of the place of beauty in his work. I think there are a few people who can find beauty in the type of technical aspects that entranced Fuller's mind, and therefore most people saw his work as producing cookie-cutter designs that reduced the human environment down to sheet metal and exposed pipes. It is too bad that Fuller was never able to develop a middle ground where his designs would be beautiful engineering feats as well as appeal to the common sense of aesthetics. Perhaps Buckminster Fuller ran afoul a common flaw of most visions of genius, the inability to share a vision of beauty with the common woman or man. Perhaps if Buckminster Fuller had been able to articulate a more flexible approach, then there would be Dymaxion homes and cars of varying aesthetic appeal and varying levels of efficiency across our country right now. The ecology of our planet is very complex, and our solutions as to how to live in that ecology will be equally complex. As I have studied other concepts in sustainability, I came to realize an important perspective about the work of Buckminster Fuller, that it is not about the specifics that the one individual was able to manifest, but the logic behind it. It's not that in the future all cars have to be three-wheeled teardrops, or that all homes need to be made of stamped sheet metal. The important thing to remember from Fuller is the Dymaxion ideal, accomplishing the most with the least. Fuller, being an engineer, applied the concept to engineering design. Being interested in sustainability and ecological design, I see Fuller's concepts at work in eco-machines, passive solar design, recycled materials, and even Paolo Soleri's concept of arcology. One of Fuller's main beliefs is that by using our intellect, we as a society could develop greater and greater efficiency so that we could have an ever-increasing standard of living despite the fact that we have limited resources. Not all of us are engineers or designers, yet this idea can be applied to any endeavor from how you get to work, how you grow your own vegetables, to which lights you turn on in the house at night. The Dymaxion attitude may be a necessary philosophical component for our sustainable future. To learn more about Buckminster Fuller, you can visit the website for the Buckminster Fuller Institute at www.bfi.org. If you are interested in building your own geodesic dome, you can visit www.domeplans.com. Any intelligent fool can make things bigger, more complex, and more violent. It takes a touch of genius and a lot of courage to move in the opposite direction. Albert Einstein. Thank you.